Why, first of all, Charles is what we are to do.
That's it.
The second is because we are so great that he saved
the
like me. I am that I can't do nothing but run around and talk about
him.
I'd like to say good morning again to our guests. We have some guests in the house. Glad to see you all. And welcome. And you are truly our honored guests. And anything that you might hear today that you don't know.
Has done nothing, you know, a baby that can't understand
what is wrong. You know, they have no reason for that. They use it today as spring for babies and say that is active. But we're going to talk about what the scriptures say. You know, because I don't like into conversations about what I feel.
Amen.
And what
Amen.
I think.
Amen.
You know, because as I get into the word today, you know, I'm going to talk about what God said, he ain't respect a person. Meaning that what I feel and what I think, and a dollar and 50 cents at 7-Eleven, you get that but what I feel and what I think, if I get a dollar and 50 cents, they don't have to be restored. Amen. You know, that's about what it equates to.
Amen.
When you talk about the word of God. You know, and then he says it again in verse 5. Jesus says it again. He says, "Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of the water and the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of heaven." And he says it again in verse 7. "Marvel not that I say unto thee, you must be born again."
Amen.
Amen, somebody. You know, there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. Nicodemus is named 3 times by John and not elsewhere in the Bible. You know, he and John 7:50-51, where he protests against condemning Jesus when they were crucified, they were locking him up. The same Nicodemus that Jesus spoke to back in John 3 about being must be born again to be saved. Now the Pharisees that stand up saying that you should not not condemning this Jesus. You know, and then in John 19:38-39, here is where he aids Joseph of Arimathea in the burial of Jesus. The same thing that came to him at night that Jesus talked about what he must do to be saved is now one of the ones that came to get his body and prepared for work. So, it never so bad that Jesus obeyed the gospel, but all these things show that something happened to Nicodemus after this conversation with Jesus. He did something, you know, because he went from being the enemy to being a friend. You know, so this man, Nicodemus, is like many people today, one who is religious, because we have a religious alphabet soup out here.
Amen.
You name it, and somebody will plan. Amen, somebody. And we are just like Nicodemus. You know, I come out of the denomination. I've been around the alphabet soup. You know, baptized 3 times. Yeah. To get it right. To get it right. You know, because you must be taught. Jesus taught Nicodemus something. They didn't fill in blanks. But if you have a conversation with Jesus, you're going to be taught something. You can guarantee that. And you gotta have an honest heart, an honest desire to want to understand what this new birth is. Because it's a big question, well, what is being born again? You know, it was a legitimate question.
Amen.
When they began to say, I can now go back and see my mother and be born again. I'm not getting this. You know? And so, here, Jesus told him, he has to have an honest heart to ask that question. You have to have an honest heart to want to understand what that new birth is. You have to have an honest heart to want to know Jesus. You have to have an honest heart, an honest desire to ask that question, what must I do? What you say. And the title of my sermon today is, have you been born again?
Amen.
Have you been born again?